In the following video, we are given with a composite cross-sectional shape. The dimensions are given in the figure. We need to find out the centroid with respect to x and y axis. The x axis is this one, y axis is this one. The centroid for x axis will be, and the centroid for y axis will be. We have to find out the location of this point with respect to x axis and with respect to y axis. We discussed the definition and calculation and formula of centroid in previous videos. Now we will apply those concepts in the question. We know that the formula for centroid is about x axis is summation of area into lever arm over summation of area. And centroid about y axis formula was summation of area into y over summation of area. So from this figure we need to extract the data for a into x, summation of area, a into y and summation of area. So let's name the individual shapes in form of numbers. Let's call this as area number 1. This as area number 2, this as area number 3, this as area number 4, and similarly 1, 2, 3 and 4 according to these names. For the formula we need to find out area, the distance x for each individual shape's centroid with respect to x axis will be x. For each individual shape's distance with respect centroid, total distance with respect to y will be y. And a multiplied by x and a multiplied by y. Upon summing for all the given, we will find summation of area and summation of area into y. The area of first shape is 1420 multiplied by 20. The area of second shape is, the height is 500 mm, 500 multiplied by 10, the thickness. The area of third shape is similarly 500 into 10 millimeters, and the area of fourth shape is 1220 into the thickness, that is 12 millimeters. Now, for working out the distance x for each individual shapes, we consider this point as origin as we are given with respect to x and y axis about point O as reference. This point O is reference. For the distance x, for this figure, that is number 1, we will find out the distance from this point to the centroid of this individual shape number 1. That will be 1420 divided by 2. Where the centroid would be somewhere here. So measuring this distance along x-axis will be 100 millimeter plus 100 was this distance plus 1220 minus this thickness as we had to reach from here till here minus a half of thickness, that is 10/2. So this is lever arm for the shape number 2. For lever arm of shape number 3, we will have distance along x-axis as 100 plus the half of thickness, that is 10/2. For the lever arm of shape number 4, along x-axis it will be 100 millimeter plus half of the length of this element. 1220/2. Similarly, working for the distance or lever arm for each shape along y-axis, that will be for shape number 1, 12 mm, 500 mm and half of 20. 12 plus 500 plus 20 over 2. For shape number 2, that is this one, that will be 12 millimeters plus the height is 500 millimeters. So it will be half of 500 millimeter for lever arm along y-axis. The same shape, 12 plus 500 divided by 2. For the shape number 4, the distance will be half of 12 millimeter from x-axis along y-axis. We will multiply A with X for all the rows. 1420 into 1420 divided by 2 will give us 2016400. 500 into 10 divided by multiplied by this factor will give us 6575000. 500 into 10 multiplied by this will give us 1220 multiplied by 12 multiplied by this gives us 1039440. Adding these all, we will get 1440. Area into y will give us the values as 1482480, 1314 zeros, 1314 zeros, and 87840. Adding these will give us 1753640. Summation of area will come out as summing up all the areas 53040. Putting these values in the formulas 3765800 divided by 53040. Gives us centroid from x-axis, from y-axis up along x-axis as 710 millimeters, and the value of centroid from x-axis along y-axis is 30.55 millimeters. Thank you for watching.